Receive best of five, love all.
One, love.
A quick start for Posotska here.
Didn't see a loss on the record for Mima Ito before the match. Now, difference in stature, I think, is also going to affect the difference from the table, as it often does. Mima Ito, 152 centimeters, just over 5 feet tall. She likes to stay right on the back edge of the table.
Yeah, she takes the ball very early, very quickly off the bounce.
I think for anyone who's using pips at all in an attack game, has to stay close to the, you know, to the table. They just don't have that spin as much on the backhand side, and a shot there.
One,
that's just
three.
How can you return that? I think that's as much spin as you can get with speed. Look at that.
Yeah, and such a great angle as well.
Jeez. I think this is what makes Mima Ito capable of beating Ding Ning in the Olympic trials. Qualification tournament in Hong Kong in 2016. That's Coach Mika Baba. She is the Jill Parker of Japan, 7-time national champion. What do you know? Hey, you guys should hang out sometime, Jill.
Yeah.
The Seven Club. That's what you guys are.
Ooh.
Both sides of the racket. She loves that corner.
Yeah, she picked that up well. She read that service.
Yeah, light top inside. I think the deception factor might not have been as high as the spin factor. So despite getting the first point, the next five go to Mima Ito. No, I say natural athlete because I've seen Mima Ito hit some crazy trick shots in the practice hall. And in Australia, we played a little football, and she was a natural first shot.
6-1.
And here, even that punchy shot out wide to the forehand side. Good combinations here. How quickly she can change the direction and how drastically. I think this sort of shadow rehearsal shows you that Mima Ito, despite being ahead by quite a bit, does take her opponent quite seriously. That's the second point for Posotska.
Three, six.
Sounds like there are some serious supporters for Ukraine in the crowd, yeah?
I think it might be the players on the bench. I think they're creating quite a noise.
Just occurred to me, I think it's probably for another table because I heard men screaming. I heard it again. I forgot there are other tables being played right now. Could have been a Hong Kong supporter. So 3 points in a row. Posotska now within 2 points of Mima Ito.
Seven, four.
Even though it touched the net, she stepped in there. She had control. Ito.
This is a good sign of calm and focus, you know, when the ball catches the net, breaks your rhythm, and you're still quite cool. Being light on your feet, not being too tense. Heavy rotation on that pendulum serve. Posotska looked like she gave it a good lift, but still it wasn't enough. Nice parallel. Jill, it's your parallel shot.
Yeah, like that one.
I believe this is our first time seeing the new uniforms for the Japanese women. Every World Championships, they get a new tracksuit and uniform, I'm told.
Stand four.
And now 6 game points for Mima Ito to take the first game with authority. Sounds like Hanimoto's in the building. A beautiful shot out wide. What a turnaround, a bit of a run there with 3 in a row from down 1-6, but not enough. Mima Ito pinches it off and takes game one. We'll be back for game two right after this. Playing this team tie, the overall team match. A strawberry there on the receive, some side spin to break the rhythm. Might have been her idea, huh?
talking to the coach for a minute between games. Have to find some answers after losing 11-4 in game one. Oh, edge of the table, but a good angle there.
Yeah, I think that good serve is like that little shovel.
Yeah.
We see, but that was a good angle.
Digging a hole in the opponent. That's not why they called it a shovel, but just having fun with that. It's funny, we were talking about the shovel serve, Will and I, last night with Anton Shellberg, and I think Mima Ito has really picked up a lot of variety in her service game. She has so much wrist on her shots and on her serve.
She steps in and takes it so quickly, doesn't it? Comes off really fast from that backhand.
Funny, if you're an indecisive person, for table tennis, you sort of need to drop that routine. You just don't have time. There's one person on that bench you might not recognize. Just in case, Miyu Nagasaki was the coach's pick. World ranked number 81, 15 years old. So the youngest on the team, a team with two 17-year-olds and an 18-year-old. Pretty interesting stuff.
A great experience for the player to be here, sitting on the bench, you know, with the Japanese team, to experience playing in an arena like this.
And I'm curious, you know, at this stage, it's no longer round robin. I think everything, because it's single elimination, probably not going to be an opportunity for her to get in the mix. Ooh, nice cover from the middle, but again, as early off the bounce as can be.
Yeah, great placement there to that crossover position. And then it popped up, took that ball early. Jeez. Set it up well.
That is so tough to do confidently. Really have to know the bounce, the spin, read it well, right off the contact. Good rotation here, mostly side spin, a little bit of top, but it's deep enough and fast enough that it rushes the shot out of Ito. Not enough time to really get a good read on the spin. Long shovel serve here. That's difficult to do. Again, the service variety, I feel like at the world-class level, all players have the ability, it seems, to do their serves to pretty much any point on the table. For example, didn't expect that one, huh? Even there, obviously an unfortunate service error for Mima Ito. Ties it up, Pasotska. Already breaking her score in game number one. It looked like the backs of Hina Hayata and Nagasaki.
Oh, that's a nice one there. Good angle with that. A backhand.
I think this is a good combination. Serve long to that backhand corner, but not deep enough so that it's a clear backhand. Mima Ito takes the bait, steps around, and Pezotska right on top of the table for the punch down the line. Wow, a finish. I mean, this is the whole point. I'm thinking Pezotska's playing everything right. Ito just doesn't let you breathe. Really doesn't give you a lot of chances, and it took, what, four shots for her to earn this finishing backhand? Divide, divide from the benches. Come on, come on. Let's go, let's go. That's three in a row from five each. Pezotska really making this a close game here. And in some senses, just pulling ahead now. Looking to tie it up at 1-1, but we've seen Ito come back from greater deficits.
We saw put a slow one in there just to break the game up. Yeah, that slow one.
Flat hit and smacked right back into the body. I mean, parallel for parallel.
8-6.
Ball coming over from the other court, hitting it back to her teammate, Harimoto. This is a big break for me. I feel like the difference between 9-6 and 8-7 when you're the underdog and you just got beaten 11-4 It's really important for her to sort of hold on to the steering wheel here.
And she's played well. She's got in whenever possible. She's playing positive.
Wow. Again, she didn't overdo it when the ball was low to the forehand. She played it spinny to set up the next ripping backhand. But she's going, as you mentioned, very positively, very aggressively whenever the ball sits up a little bit. Four game points for Pozetska. And she takes it 11-6, tied up at one game apiece. This could be a very defining match. We'll see what happens. Game number three coming up after this. In game number one, back on the winning side of the table. Well, Jill, you and I were talking. If this match goes the way of Pozetska, I mean, Tatiana Bielenko is a strong number two here. In theory, she beats Kasumi Ishikawa. Not impossible. That's a 2-0 lead for Ukraine. You were talking about the team they played earlier in the tournament?
Yeah, because Ishikawa, she beat Hood, H-U-D, Veronica, who was ranked 677, so they played, obviously, the young player there. And then Ito, she beat Gapanova. And then they played Bratejko. So Bielenko didn't play.
Interesting.
Pozetska didn't play.
Yeah. So they're bringing out their A players, their aces, the big guns here for the elimination rounds in the rematch against Japan. Last time they played, it was 3-0 for Japan, yeah?
That's right, yeah.
Classic trick. Want to play a quick pickup game of table tennis, and then you win 3-0 second time around. You take it a little bit easy when it counts. But we'll see. It's still going to be an uphill battle. But so far, Pozetska giving a good fight. Chance to tie it up here.
Nice spinny, slow spinny ball there.
I feel like she's very specific in the placement of these backhand serves. Heavy rotation, low to the net, and a confident third ball. I mean, we've seen her play very ambitious backhands with a high percentage. Benito also has generated a lot of spin on her serves, as we saw there.
Well, that was a little bit ambitious there by Pozetska.
But she did go for a spin.
Yeah.
It wasn't a flat hit, so trying to play the odds as well. Yeah! And this time, similar shot, just calibrates a little bit better, gets it back over the net. Davai, davai, the bench screams. Oh, nice save, but just too far behind the table for the angles that Mima Ito creates when she's that close.
Yeah, good angles there, plays it round the table, but there's that nice, nice one down the line that opens it up for the diagonal ball.
We had a strawberry, Mima Ito, with that side spin early in the point. Didn't seem to bother Pozetska too much. Angles, angles. This is Ito, right on top of the bounce. Mika Baba, the coach in the corner, left-handed pen holder. Pretty interesting style. It's interesting how the game has changed over the years. You can see so many pen holders now on the Japanese women's team. I actually can't think of one currently, but the lineup runs so deep. Got about 30 professional players on the women's side in Japan.
Five, seven.
This is not a comfortable lead. Within 2 points, especially with the serve and third ball that Pozetska has had, Ito's not safe.
Five,
what are you thinking, Jill?
I think she should have got to that one. It's a bit of a stretch.
Just a little bit late to get in. Caught it while it was low. Window had closed. Is the assistant umpire waiting for confirmation from the umpire that the point was as it appeared? Oh, what a receive.
Picked that up so well, didn't she?
Wasn't an easy serve. Watch the body language of Ito. Watch the shoulders here. Looks like she's going the other way, but then leaves the arm behind and the wrist back and plays it deep to the corner. Inside out once again. Ito now, from a two-point lead, has five game points to go up 2-1. Forehand, flat hit, kills the ball, 11-5. Strawberry from the start, and Ito once again prevails victorious here in game number three. It's a 2-1 lead, and we'll be back for game number four right after this. We will see Mima Ito leading 2-1 with the serve. Inside out forehand once again. And the fact that you don't see Kasumi Ishikawa there, she's getting ready for her match. I'm curious how many choppers the Japanese women's team brought for sake of practice. I can't recall who I saw. We got a timeout here on the side of Pesotska. But I will say that a lot of the practice partners, you know, the Japanese women have, practice partners have on the Japanese women's level. That was a lot of work to get in there. I mean, Pesotska's playing very well, trying to find the middle and the wide corners. And a smaller player, normally the wide corners are a little bit easier to reach and get past the opponent. But Mima Ito's so fast, very compact in her stroke. Set. They've been calling lets very quickly. Sometimes I watch the umpire to see if it's a service it's warning.
Short service.
And sure please it was. Higher toss, please, he
one,
says.
Two.
Must be 6 inches up from the palm, nearly vertical, hit on its way down.
Two,
and that was a good throw up there. And she followed that in with a strong backhand.
Of course, Jill referring to the toss.
I am. She made sure she didn't want to get faulted.
Three,
right.
Two.
She had to throw up properly, make sure that she didn't get faulted.
Oh, I didn't realize I'd said that.
Good times, good times. Eventually, I'll graduate from elementary school. You'll be able to say whatever you want. Ooh, top edge of the racket. Just past the head of Ito. See how quick the reaction time is, though. Watch this. Duck and cover. Sort of like Koki Niwa while the ball's still in play against pitch.
Yeah, there's that nice long shovel serve. She puts in every now and again just to surprise her opponent.
It looks like, I don't know, that looked like the mannequin challenge. Like everybody was holding still as the camera was moving through the room. So Pesotska tying it up. I'm quite impressed with Pesotska's play. I mean, world rank 182 against world rank number 7 has been giving some close games here. Well, she won 111-6. She's playing tight right now, but this sits up a little bit too high. Has to be, so it has to be a really good read for this Strawberry. She came into it with the wrist already a little bit broken. It didn't have as much spin on it as you normally would get in that shot.
Yeah, not as whippy action with the wrist.
4-6.
It's interesting, Ukraine, it's the first time in history that they've reached the quarterfinals of the World Championship, so it's a good feat for them.
All right, Ukraine.
Five, six.
Now we remember this setup before. Pesotska serves. We got the timeout here. To Mima Ito wants to regather herself. Pesotska serving long to the backhand, but not so deep to the backhand corner that Ito still is tempted to turn the corner. Her natural tempo is enough to finish the point. Interesting.
Six,
a little bit softer here. Slightly spinnier. Huh. That's very peculiar. Especially for a ball that height. For Ito, normally She is pretty free on that. So out of the timeout, first point goes the other way. This point is so well played. Ito plays the first two patiently, then comes in with the big gun, starts ripping. Pezotska stays in there for the first, four shots of this? But Ito gets her behind the table, then softens it up a little bit, and that's when it's spun up and out because it's played from out in front. Difficult shot to hit. That kick serve. Kick and shovel, Jill.
Yeah, she's won a few points with that serve.
How a strawberry is done. Let Mima Ito show you that. There are a handful of women. Miu Kato for the Japanese women's team, the strawberry farmer, the most aggressive strawberries I've seen in the game. But behind her, Mima Ito, Simone Gozi, really know how to do that receive well. Perfect placement right into the middle.
Exactly.
And now it is four game and match points for Mima Ito to take the first for Japan. And what could be a 3-0 victory, a repeat from the last time, even against their top team. Ooh, a little bit off the top of the net. Match points saved. Miu Nagasaki there, 15-year-old on the right. Bright future ahead, coaches believe in her. Why they're investing in putting her on the bench, bringing her here to grow her experience, wisdom, nerves.
Picked up that serve well. Wasn't an easy serve, but she knows she's got to take that initiative to try and get in whenever possible.
You can see the guarded optimism on the side of Ukraine. Clapping on their player, but not getting overly excited just yet. 2 points away. And now within one, Ito's timeout is already gone. Three match points saved. Pressure starts to build on the 17-year-old Mima Ito. This one looked like it had less rotation, a good length, low to the net. This is a very difficult serve to handle. Huh. Jill, it's pretty surprising.
What was a surprising shot, Nat?
Oh, tough handcuffing serve. Getting that defensive receive. It was a little bit long. She realized she couldn't keep it short. Tried to play it baseline to the table. Now match point back again. Fifth match point for Mima Ito. Just cleaning the table to make sure she gets an honest bounce.
Yeah!
Well, that well, not with that back end. Very spinny. Ito not quite getting over the ball.
It's funny, at times like this for me, it's really a big indicator of how someone performs under pressure. You've got your back against the ropes. It's quite important for your team, for their chances, to stay in this match and take the first match overall. And now game point to Pezotska. What, 5 match points for Mima Ito. This receive from middle of the table. This could be tension. It could be nerves on Ito that the serve's coming a little bit too long.
Yeah, I think it was a little too long. Made it easier for Pezotska to get in.
So game point, Pezotska. Oh, right on the line. Beautiful turn. Pezotska, you could see what she was going for the middle, but it seemed a little bit more decisively to the forehand, and Ito's quick to turn. Fourth towel break, no towel used. Third deuce point.
She didn't miss that shovel serve that time.
So I'm quite curious. You got the serve on Pesotska's side. That backhand serve has been trouble for Ito on many occasions. The third ball has been set up. to find balance here, looking for the shot, but not forcing it if the receive doesn't allow for it. Oh, a little break off the top of the net. Ito with the apology, but trying to stay focused here. That was the net. Good placement here on the receive. I mean, it was as wide as could be to Ito, who had to spin it up slowly. Steps around, plays it from table height. Soltzka just keeps it deep to that backhand corner. As aggressive as those pips are, they still generate a little bit less rotation than that forehand. So it means it's a lower percentage shot for Ito. Soltzka with another game point. Whoa, handles the strawberry, stays on top of the next ball with heavy spin, and a very focused Margarita Pesotska takes game number four to send us to a deciding fifth. Pressure builds for both, but I think it's going to be more pressure on Ito right now. Stay right here for the decider coming up after this. 2-2 game number five. Good job by Ito, staying on top of the slightly more defensive play, the fishing shots. Pesotska puts the power on when she feels comfortable here. Tries to guide it back and make her way back into the table, but Ito keeps the pressure on. Incredible points.
Oh, she's keeping up to speed with her. Lazowska.
Not many can. I mean, Mima Ito, outside of the Chinese national team, just seems to steamroll through most players. By world ranking, this is the lowest of the three representing Ukraine. Little reminder, Ukraine, number 15 team, the number 15 seeds. Japan, the number 2 seeds, the team we all expect to see face China in the final.
1-3.
First point here for Pesotska. A little appetizer for the main meal to come if she can continue going. I mean, Jill, I don't know how much time you spend thinking about the question, if anyone could, well, what are the chances that someone could upset China in this tournament? But the only conversation really is Japan.
Yeah, I think they're the only team that could compete against Japan, against China.
Well, interestingly enough, in 2015 at the Dubai World Team Cup, the big surprise visitors were Korea DPR, known as North Korea to some, to many, I guess. They upset Japan, they upset, I think, Germany, maybe Hong Kong. I don't remember all the details, but they played China in the final, and it was 2-5 gamers with 11-9 in the fifth, and Ding Ning and Liu Shiwen were both there. So now with Korea DPR and so North and South Korea together, there might be one other team that's strong enough to be a contender. I'm curious to see.
That could be the case, because, I mean, the DPR team, we don't often see them coming out in world events. So they've got quality players, so some are unknown.
After all, I mean, it was Japan's top player at the Olympic Games, top performer anyway, Ai Fukuhara, who got beaten by Kim Song-I, the chopper, who took the bronze medal 2016. So no stranger to pressure. Pesotska, though, within one. They're just pulling ahead. This just reminds me, you know, you watch young players. Ma Long, before 2015, was still incredibly impressive head-to-head with pretty much everybody, but really found his true confidence under pressure 2015. Mima Ito, Guinness Book of World Record holder for, I don't know, like 3 different things, but still, the World Championships, it's quite a beast of pressure. It's the biggest tournament this year. Oh, the angle. The combinations here, we've got the spinny backhand, the big forehand, and one even bigger right back to the wide corner, Jill.
Yeah, she's got a fantastic angle there on that forehand. You see it here, that spinny backhand sets it up. Lovely angle there.
It's a risky shot. I mean, you're watching this in real time thinking, what's coming next? Who would have guessed it would be that wide? Takes a chance, goes bold, and changes halves of the table now with the lead. She was down 0-3. Sometimes I think it pumps you up to know that you've already broken a record. This is the farthest your team has gone, the furthest I should say, I guess, in a world team championships. But what if we could go even further, right? What if we could make it, what if the British boys beat Japan in Malaysia and played the final against China? They were sure close to doing it. And then they got their revenge here. But maybe Ukraine has the same sense of motivation right now, like we can do anything.
Well, she's playing extremely well and playing very positively. As you say, she doesn't look like a world ranking 182 player.
5-7.
Ito getting a bit more security here on the step round, a little bit more confidence for that length of the table cross-court shot. Second towel break and a bit of a run. 3 points in a row for Ito from down 4-5. From that net camera, you could see the ball maybe even a little bit below the top of the net when Ito hit it, but still very confident and driven. Oh, almost. It was right there waiting for Ito. Not an easy shot, but we've seen her make tougher ones for sure. Pesotska, really impressive right now. I mean, these aren't simple rallies. This isn't just a third ball. We're getting into seventh ball, ninth ball attacks here. Right down the middle with the backhand and dead even. I mean, in terms of upsets, you know, we see a World 300 beat world number one Dmitry Ovcharov a few months ago in league play, but at the World Championships? Under pressure, the number two team, Japan. Their world ranked number seven, Mima Ito, playing the first spot.
Seven, all.
And she's you know, matching her speed for speed.
Cracking shots. I mean, she's just laser focused right now, spinning when it's low, countering deep on the table. Look at how much speed is on that, and it's only to set up the winner. Still didn't finish the point. They are going back and forth in this tug of war. Mima Ito looking to defend, to protect, to deliver what was expected. Yeah! That was the most awkward start to a point I've seen in a long time. Slower serve, length between the bounces here, pushback soft and deep. 2 points away from what could be the biggest upset of the Champions Division. By world ranking, I can't imagine it wouldn't be. Ooh, just missing the line. She hung in there for that receive. It's a very unusual. So Mima Ito's the only person that does the banana split where she comes at it with side spin and sometimes a little bit of under. Much like a banana Chiquita, but it saves the point. Well, eventually, much further down the road. Jill, this is getting thick.
Yes, it certainly is, but both players playing extremely well. Let's see what she can do with her serve.
And now two game and match points for Margarita Pesotska. Reminder, Ukraine already breaking their record. Smiles starting to come out. They can't believe it. This isn't over yet. Third towel break. And Ito looking a bit deflated. We will see if the body language is any indicator of performance out here. She has the serves on her side. Ooh, quick points. And it's easy to say, did she lose focus? Who knows? It could just be that Mima Ito upped her game for that serve. But one more match point here for Pesotska on the receive. Oh, wow. Almost deja vu from the point before. They were both short points. They looked a little bit sloppy after all the hard work. Pesotska's played some amazing rallies. Maybe Ito just sort of dictated the point well here to change the pace and get these soft shots back.
Yeah, I think she put a float serve in there, just popped up slightly. She stepped in.
So two match points saved by the 17-year-old. Oh, and flat hit back, three in a row. Good coach Mika Baba there, rocking out in the corner. I mean, there's no question how she feels about this. And with a shot like that, how can you not be pumped on the Japanese side? Flags waving in the back. So now match point, the first match point for Mima Ito after saving two, and she has the serve. Yeah! Ooh, match point saved the other way. Well, if this wasn't worth the price of admission, it's what, the first match of my day anyway. And really, this is such a big indicator because Ukraine needs this. If they take the first match, this really opens some doors and some opportunities. Otherwise, it becomes a really uphill battle. Just a little bit flat, a little bit behind it.
She played that one well. Ito well into her body there.
You could see she just wanted to come through the ball, wanted to hit it a little bit harder. When you get close to the finish line, sometimes things change with the desire. Match point back to Ito. And 17-year-old Mima Ito saves the game, two match points, and takes the match. What a performance from Pesotska, really pressing and challenging world number 7.